Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. Each smart home must have a secure network. And sometimes you have to access the network from outside your home. That means the network should be securely accessible from anywhere in the world. Now there are a few ways to achieve it, but then you need to open some ports or poke some holes in your firewall. And that's not a very secure way to do it. That's where free Cloudflare Tunnel service will come in handy. Cloudflare Tunnels will not only help us avoid poking holes in our firewall, but will also provide us fully secure and encrypted connection to all our services. Okay, so now what do we need to set up Cloudflare Tunnels? We need three things. The first one is definitely Cloudflare Account. We can sign up for free Cloudflare account by going to Cloudflare website. The second one is a domain name. The third one is a Synology NAS. And we need Synology NAS to set up a connector between our local area network and the Cloudflare servers. There are many other ways to set up this connector, but the beauty of setting it up in Synology NAS using a Docker container is it will be totally GUI based. And there will be no command line interface involved. All right, so how this whole process will work? First, we will point our domain name to Cloudflare server. Once that is done, then we will install a connector inside our local area network. In this case, we will be installing that connector in our Synology NAS. And then we will be creating separate qualified domain names for each service. So let's say we have a Synology NAS. We will be creating a subdomain, a fully qualified domain name for Synology NAS. We have UDM Pro. We will be creating a separate subdomain or fully qualified domain name for this one, and to any other services which we want to access. Now, when any access request for a specific resource or a service is generated, it will be pointed to Cloudflare servers. Because we have pointed a domain name to the Cloudflare server. Now, the Cloudflare server will be talking to the connector, which in our case is Synology NAS. Let's say in this case, we have requested access for a CCTV system. In that case, Cloudflare will talk to the connector, and then if all the authentication is approved, it will route to the CCTV system. Now, what are the advantages of using Cloudflare? The first one is we will not be opening any ports. The second one is all our connections, they will be secured, encrypted SSL connections, and all of them will be handled by the Cloudflare. Since we will be using fully qualified domain names to access our resources, for example, nas.mydomain.com, which will be resolving to Cloudflare IP addresses. That means we will not be exposing our public IP address ever to the internet. And this will also work in case you are behind CGNet issue from your ISP. I think we have discussed enough. Let's jump to the tutorial. So the first step is to create a Cloudflare account. I have already created a Cloudflare account. But if you haven't done that already, you can go to Cloudflare website and sign up for a free account. In my case, I'll simply log in. Once you have created your new Cloudflare account and you're on the dashboard, click on the Add Site button. Enter the domain name which you want to use to access your network. Click Continue. Now we need to select a plan. In this case, we don't need to select any paid plan. The free plan is good enough for us. So I'll select free plan and we'll click continue. Cloudflare will scan the DNS records on the domain. My case, I don't have anything because this is fairly new domain. So I will click continue. So it's just giving me a warning that Cloudflare might not activate my site without any DNS records. So that's fine for now. I'll confirm that one. Now in this step, Cloudflare is guiding me to update my domain name to Cloudflare servers. In your case, this might be a bit different. You need to follow documentation in your domain name provider, how to point your domain name to Cloudflare servers. In my case, since I have registered my domain name with the Seller Club, so I'll simply copy the domain name server mentioned on this page onto my domain name portal to point my domain name to the Cloudflare server. And then go back to Cloudflare website. Now we can click on check name servers now. This might take some time. It might take from 5 to 20 minutes because Cloudflare have servers all over the world, so it should be fairly quick. While the domain name propagation is in progress, let's click continue and then look at this quick start guide. Let's click on get started. I will leave most of the setting as default. I'll click on save. The next setting, I will always use HTTPS. So if it is not enabled for you, just enable this one, click on save. Then the last one, leave at default, then finish the setup. Now we will wait until our domain name is fully propagated to the Cloudflare servers. Once this is done, we should receive an email and this portal page should update telling us that domain name is now active. Okay, I just got this email now, literally after 5 minutes, that domain name propagation has been completed. So now our domain is active, up and running. So now we are ready to set up our tunnel. So in the Cloudflare portal home, from the left menu bar, select Zero Trust and then click on access. On this screen, you might be seeing some applications which might not be present in your case. Definitely, I have created this application because I have been using this Cloudflare portal for all my remote accesses, so you can ignore these ones for now. So just click on tunnels. So again, I have already created a couple of tunnels in here, but in your case, this portal will be totally empty if you haven't used this one already. So click on create tunnels, give it a name, I will, and then click on save tunnel. And then here you can select any platform which you are going to use for your tunnel. It can be Windows, Mac, Debian, Red Hat. As we discussed earlier, in our case, we will be using Docker on Synology NAS. So I will select Docker and then we have to run this command in our Docker on Synology NAS to create this connector. And this connector will then be talking to the Cloudflare server and that will be routing traffic from Cloudflare server to our local network. Alright, to set up the connector, let's go to Synology NAS and set up our Docker container. In Synology NAS, I've already set up container manager. You have to do it if you haven't done it already. Start the container manager, go to registry, and then search for Cloudflare D. Now select on the first daemon, which is the official Cloudflare D Docker, then click on download. It will ask us to choose the tag, so we'll select the latest, which is fine, and click apply. It will start downloading. Once the download is completed, select and click on run, give your container a name, and check enable or restart. So this will basically restart the container just in case the Synology NAS reboots. Click on next. So in this page, we need to modify a few settings. So the first one, port setting, we don't need to do anything. Volume setting is also fine. We can ignore the environment setting and the capabilities, the network setting. So we don't need to use a bridge network. We are happy with the host one. So we'll select the container to use the host network. Next one is the execution command. So this is the command which we will be using as per the Cloudflare portal. So here we will be tweaking the command from the Cloudflare portal a little bit. So to do that easily, I would recommend to copy the whole command from the Cloudflare portal and paste it in any text editor of your choice. Remove anything which is before the word tunnel, and also remove this no arrow update as well. Everything else is fine. So now we can just copy this one and then go back to our container on Synology NAS and then paste back in there. Just make sure there is no extra spaces in there. So select next, review the settings, and then click done. Container has been created. So let's go to the overview. You can see the two containers which are up and running. So let's select containers. So the Cloudflare service is running fine. So let's jump back to the Cloudflare portal, and we can see a container is connected. That means our Cloudflare tunnel is up and running. Just a side note, I understand that everybody can see my connector ID, and I know that this is not secure, but this is purely for the tutorial, and I will be destroying both tunnel and the connector by the time this video goes live. So now our connector is connected, so let's get back to the tutorial. Click next, and now we can start creating our services. The first one which I want to create is for my Synology NAS. So I just enter, let's say NAS, and select my domain name. And select the service. I'll give it a plain HTTP because that's a plain HTTP service on my local area network. I'll provide an IP address for my NAS here, followed by the port number. This is one of my test analogies there. So I'll save the tunnel. And now we can see a newly created tunnel is appearing in there. To test it, let's click on the tunnel, click on configure, and then look at the public host names. Here we can see the first host name which we created previously. So to test this one, click on the host name and then click on the URL. There you go. So I can see my login page for my Synology NAS, and we can check the connection is secure because this is encrypted and it is under a valid SSL certificate. Similarly, we can create few more services here just to show you. So we'll go back to the portal again and then add a public host name. And then here in this case, we'll be adding, let's say, speed test. I'll select my domain name, select the service and the IP address. So this is my open speed test IP address and the port name. So I'll click save. Back to the host name again to test this one. My speed test portal loading up. So again, we can verify the certificate and the SSL connection, which is secure. Let's create another service. In this case, I'll create my UDM. Select the domain name. Okay, let's test the third service and click. Now this time it didn't work. Why it didn't work? Because my UDM by default is using the HTTPS connection. So that means I need to go back to the configure section and change the service type to HTTPS. So let's change it and then click on save hostname. Now we can try one more time. Go to the public hostname and click on the UDM subdomain. This time it did work partially. We can see the Cloudflare Tunnel page, but there is any configuration error on the host side. To troubleshoot that configuration error, let's go back to the tunnel again. In the tunnel, click on configure and then click on the additional application setting link. That will open up more options. Then click on TLS. In the TLS, you can see a toggle for no TLS verify. So basically, this option is forcing the system to verify the SSL certificate presented by the host. Now that our UDM is using the HTTPS by default, but there is no certificate present at the origin at the moment. So that's why the system is throwing up an error. So if we will enable this toggle, that means system will not verify the certificate at origin and it will be handled by the Cloudflare. So enable it and click on save, and then we can go back and verify the connection again. This time it worked and Dream Machine login page is displayed. This is how we set up Cloudflare Tunnels to access our home network remotely. As you can see, this is very easy and straightforward, but there is a problem with the setup. That is, our local application or resources are now accessible through public host names. Even though we haven't opened any ports or we haven't poked any holes into our firewall, still we need to enhance the security of our services through authentication. I have created another video on how to increase the security of our services which are using Cloudflare Tunnels. If you are using Cloudflare Tunnels, I highly recommend you to watch that video. I'll share the link to that video down in the description below. That's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.